Hello, my name is Casamato, and a warm welcome to my presentation about my paper, Learning to be Exact, Cell Detection for Asthma on Partially Annotated Wood Slide Images. Let me start by giving you a short introduction into the medical background. Asthma is a chronic inflammatory disorder of the lower respiratory tract system. The gold standard for detecting asthma in the field of veterinary pathology is to perform a cytology of bronchial lavage fluid. This fluid is collected from the lung of the horse, for example, stained with Meyer-Grünwald and digitalized using a whole slide image. Then asthma is detected based on the relative proportion of five types of cells, as you can see in the bottom of the slide. There are many more cells in this samples, but we are just interested in the proportion of this five. Let me now continue with the motivation and introduce you to the data set. The data set for this paper consists of six slides, expertly annotated, which resulted in 87,000 labeled cells. Two of the slides are fully annotated and four slides are only partially annotated. For grading asthma, you have to count between 300 and 500 cells. So an object detection model aiding a pathologist in the start would be highly valuable. Furthermore, using data augmentation or expert algorithm collaboration, creating a model on this partially annotated data set could help annotate the rest of the slides. On the right side, we see the six example images, and here we see a patch collected from this image and can easily identify computer vision challenges like multiple cell types, closely packed, different cell sizes, and we have an extreme class imbalance. We will look closer into on the next slide. On this slide, we see the data distribution. Especially the eosinophils are quite interesting. We have just a few of them compared to the total number of annotations. So finding a good sampling strategy is key. We will go into this topic on the next slide. Furthermore, we see here our screened area. Two slides are completely screened by an expert and annotated. Other slides are just screened for 1%. Now, without further ado, let's go dive into the sampling approach. On the last slide, we see a strong class imbalance. How can we tackle this class imbalance? Well, the idea is, while our expert screens the data set, we use the exact server to mark and save where our expert actually screened which areas of the slide he annotated and viewed. So this is here, these green rectangles, these are parts of the slide which are completely annotated. Then we use this red area because, well, if we take patches from 1024 by 1024, we don't want to sample from areas which are not annotated, so we define this red area. And then we can basically freely sample from this area, but we have this one class imbalance, so we build up a training batch of, for example, size 8, and the first image of this batch is the most rarest type of cells, then the second most, and so on. With that sampling strategy, we get very well results. But that we will see on the next slide. So let's dive a little bit more into the training pipeline. We use again a retinoid implementation for detecting cells with different backbones. The patch size of 24 by 1024. This patch size is motivated by our cell structure because we have some very small cells, 50 by 50 pixels, and we have some quite huge cells with a couple of hundred by a couple of hundred pixels. So to find a patch size which cover both of them, we have to take this very large one. We use some pretty standard augmentation techniques and a learning weight schedule as mentioned in the bottom of the slide. Here we see our ground truth and the predictions, which are quite good results actually. Diving a little bit deeper into the results, we see here our method with this provide sampling strategy and a classical sub-image based approach where we use our whole slide image, dump the slides to the hard drive and train and so on them. We can see, especially on the type of this rare cells, our model outperforms sub-image based approach by quite large margin. We attribute this to a very good augmentation technique with this randomly sampling cells compared to the sub-image patches, where the patches are basically predefined. We also tried this different network backbones and see, okay, the results are not really increasing with bigger models. So now let's finalize our talk with the discussion, and we will see a use case example on the next slide. We created a ready-to-use application which you can for detecting asthma on whole slide images, but there's pretty strong limitations because we only have 6 images and just one scanner and one expert. So generalizability is a huge issue and topic for the future. Our sampling method proved to be superior to simple sub-image based approaches, and the results are independent of the tested backbone model, allowing to further decrease the backbone size, for example with a mobile net, to get to results even faster. So yeah, we also see a reduced overfitting, and this model can be the basis for further augmented annotation for the remaining slides and more in the future to come. So now on this final slide, we see a short video of the exact application. You can find the QR code here. We have here 2 cells, 2 eosinophils, and are on this whole slide imager. Now we use the inference plugin from the exact server, load the asthma detection model, and yeah, perform inference. So in the first step, the model will be downloaded and inference performed. So we see, okay, the model was able to find these 2 eosinophil cells. Now we can submit the information after we check them and save them at the server. Then we can go into an automatic mode, screen the slide, and all eosinophils will be highlighted.